We are a movement. By and for people affected by multiple sclerosis.
Until we end this disease forever, we will do whatever it takes
to accelerate breakthroughs.
We believe that we are stronger together.
That nobody should face MS alone.
We will be by your side every step of your journey.
From day one.
Be your partner through the challenges.
Sharing ideas and finding solutions.
We believe
that people live better lives
when they are understood and supported.
It's hard to hear.
But you look so good.
When you feel anything but.
Or to feel like MS is the only thing people see.
We will be there for your loved ones so they can be there for you.
We'll shine a light on what it means to live with MS.
Till the rest of the world understands.
We believe that everyone deserves affordable medications.
A doctor who knows MS.
And a healthcare system that puts you first.
You should never have to choose
between paying your bills
and getting the care you need.
We will make sure your voice is heard
loud
and clear.
We'll be your champion
from the halls of Congress
to City Hall.
We believe that you should be able to plan for the next 10 years.
Even the next 10 minutes.
Without MS getting in the way.
Complex problems take many solutions.
Coming together in just the right way.
We'll be there to help you piece it all together.
We'll work every day
so you can get what you want from life.
Even while living with this disease.
We believe that no one else should have to face the fear
and uncertainty
of an MS diagnosis.
And that those that have MS
should get back what they've lost.
Curing this disease takes a global effort.
We will fund the most
promising leads
and gather the brightest minds
to find a cure
as fast as possible.
We'll be unrelenting
until the very
end.
We believe that we all have something to contribute.
Whether it's time,
money,
connections,
or sheer passion,
there is strength in numbers.
We're calling on you to join us.
Join us.
Join us.
Find your place in this movement.
We need you.
We need you.
We need you.
Together, we will create a world free of MS.
Which one should we pick? Hereditary hemochromatosis, chronic costochondritis, narcolepsy, or multiple sclerosis? Let's shoot them all down. The most devastating year in world history during the last century was this year. Okay? Imagine we're having a world war with COVID-19, because that's what was going on. The Spanish influenza was killing millions and millions of people, and guys in the trenches were dying. That's what was happening. Worst year of the last century, 1917. World War, worldwide pandemic, can't be stopped. And to quote my friend Master Rawl, it's an old game, but it's still a beautiful game. Right on. Old games can still be so doggone pretty, can't they? But if you do tune in, thanks for tuning in. Thanks for listening to what I had to say. And I'm hoping to feel better sooner than later.
The French, in particular, were quick to exploit their aces. By focusing on the lives of the heroes of the air, they could distract the public from the carnage of the trenches. Successful pilots were courted by the press and paraded in high society. The Germans, too, were quick to celebrate their aces.
In the German service, it was actually used as a positive tool to boost morale, but also not only boost morale amongst the pilots, but also to create heroes for the population back home. So we get scores being published, we get people, pilots competing with each other, and medals are actually given for shooting down a certain amount of aircraft.
The best known German ace was Manfred von Richthofen, the Red Baron. Von Richthofen would shoot down 80 enemy planes, more than any other pilot in the war.
I am a hunter. When I have shot down an Englishman, my hunting passion is satisfied for just a quarter of an hour.
Von Richthofen became the icon of a romantic view of the air war. Individual knights in shining armor of airborne steel, locked in hand-to-hand combat.
To be alone, to have your life in your own hands, to use your own skill single-handed against the enemy. It was like the jousts of the Middle Ages, the only sphere in modern warfare where a man saw his adversary and faced him in mortal combat. The only sphere where there was still chivalry and honor. If you won, it was your own bravery and skill. If you lost, it was because you had met a better man.
But oh, my old ma, one can't lay down the rules while on mere earth for people on fighting patrol in the air. You are a different man. At least, you aren't a man at all. That is, I am not. You are a devil incarnate filled with the dazzling thrill of playing the best game God ever created. Mad after Huns and just forgetting everything else. But showing the old Hun that there's only one man fit to be in the air, and not two.
In a battle area, where the shells are bursting around you and all black smoke and all the rest of it, you become a different individual. You do not become human, can I put it that way? You do not, in a sense, become human, you're a war machine. And so that's what you do.
By April 1917, the Germans were again forging ahead in the tit-for-tat arms race. Part of their advantage was tactical. They began to operate in squadrons of 14 aircraft called Jasters, sending three or four Jasters over the lines at a time. These massive groups became known as the Flying Circuses. The Jasters led to the first great scenes of squadrons rather than individuals dueling, the famous days of the dogfights. British and Allied squadrons would meet the German circuses in the skies over the trenches and battle to the death, often to the amazement of infantrymen below. Superior German planes and the Jaster tactics cost the Allies dear. In 1917, in what became known as Bloody April, they lost 150 aircraft and 316 men. Later in 1917, the first American pilots came over, but German superiority continued.
Yet the Allied airmen... All right, guys. Hope you guys enjoyed that quick reel. That was a pretty good reel. Explained a lot about what's going on in the time period, Bloody April 1917, that we're flying in tonight. So I'm going to jump in with the Flying Circus and Manfred Vaughn and fly another mission with our man, Alfred Sturm. Hope you guys had a good day. What's a day or a week like with multiple sclerosis? I haven't had a bath in a week. I haven't eaten since Thursday. That's multiple sclerosis. But I want to jump in and fly a mission tonight. It's Saturday. And guys, I have some new videos on my Daryl Tungit YouTube channel. It has a lot more of my MS stuff, and if you're interested in what's going on with me and my health and that sort of thing, tune into that channel for my latest videos. I'm pretty sick. I've been pretty sick for a couple of days. So, my friends, let's fly. You can do it. Full canvas jacket. Sorry for the loudness, guys. Bloody April, baby. This is really loud, too. I'm going to bypass it. Let's see what we're looking at. Our campaign, our pilot log. We were playing Carl Bodenschatz the other day. So we're going to go back to our man. So Carl's got 5 kills in the, during the Fokker, at the end of the Fokker Scourge in 1916, early in the war. And again, Carl Bodenschatz is the author and exo of the Flying Circus, and he's the author of Jagd und Flandershimmel, 18 months with the Flying Circus. And so, guys, we are going to... Oh! I hope I didn't just delete that. Okay, good, I didn't. Awesome. Alfred Sturm, so we're April... date of enlistment, right on. So what's the current date? April 13th. Let's hope it's not a Friday. Right? So yeah, let's fly Alfred Sturm. Squad ops intelligence, we've probably seen all that squad ops, squad info. I am supposed to have a D3. I'm not considered an ace yet. I think we have like 10 victories. We need 12 more to be considered an ace. Yeah. Lothar, we're flying with Lothar, Manfred, Kurt Wolf, we're flying with all the aces from Yasta 11, Yasta 10, Yasta 6, Yasta 4, Ernst Udet, all right? Eric Lowenhart, I could go on. But in any event, guys, we're gonna have some fun. This should be a good mission. I'll try not to die. Cool beans, Manfred Vaughn. And so we're supposed to have a D3, and we painted that the last... I was streaming, I think, a week ago. I was streaming this. Yeah. So, we'll see it in the air. Cool deal. Killboard, how we sitting? I think, man... Yeah, we're number 2. We've got 16 victories. So, yeah, we need... 6 more victories. Probably 6 more victories for our Blue Max. That's the goal. Rock and roll. Christoph Eisenlohr. Lothar has 3 victories. And he will be getting a lot more. Lothar went on to help form Lufthansa, Germany's first passenger airline after World War I, is what the Red Baron's younger brother went on to do. I believe he was killed in the 1920s during one of those Lufthansa flights, is how he met his end. Man, we got a lot of balloons. We got 7 balloons. We've shot down 4 Newport 17s, and boy, they are badass. And we've actually shot down 1 SOP with PUP. Was really tough. I believe we downed and wounded for life and sent home for good Billy Bishop. He was our first ace kill. He was like the second Newport that we shot down, maybe the third. And so that was really cool. For our first mission, we went up against an ace, and it was squad versus squad. So cool. Intel reports.
You just to learn how to shoot? Will you dad say to shoot or no? What the hell are you doing? I want to shoot something. What do you want me to shoot? I got to go for siesta now. You being silly.
You know, I've lost over 100 pounds just sitting here this year. They're right across the front from us, I believe. The Lafayette Escadrille Americaine. All the American volunteers, because America's not, the United States is not fully invested in the war at all. But a lot of Americans went over and did their part. Top aces of the day, probably Manfred Vaughn with 40. He just passed up George Guinemere. Albert Ball still sitting at 31. He scores 10 more victories before he is killed in an epic dogfight. It's always been up for debate, but Lothar von Richthofen was credited with shooting down Albert Ball. It's always been an article of debate that the Germans used that for propaganda, that Lothar shot down Albert Ball. We'll never know. Albert Ball's no longer around for us to ask. and Werner Voss with his awesome mustache face on the front of his triplane. Charles Neungesser, man, I really wouldn't want to go up against him. Gina Miro being a spad. Yeah, cool beans. I want to jump around and fly a lot of different stuff. I want to fly a Bavarian Jagdgeschwader campaign. Like I said, we might hop around and do a few different missions in a few different areas of this war that I'm particularly well-versed at. RNAS-10, I'd love to fly over the channel, man. I'd love to shoot down a Zeppelin, right? Bitchin'. So let's scoot. Let's go in. We have some medals. We do. We got the big fancy box. And I believe last week during our live stream on Twitch, we were awarded the Hohenzollern Horse Order. Emperor Wilhelm von Hohenzollern, the last emperor of Germany. And so that's the Knight's Cross of the House of Hohenzollern. So you're actually a knight of the emperor's house. That's pretty cool. And so I got that for my 16th kill in recognition of your acts of bravery on April 9th. Awesome. Yeah, so we were awarded that during our last stream. That was cool. And I think that's it. Let's see what our next mission is. Hasenbein, Richthofen, Unteroffizier Sturm, Leutnant von Richthofen. So we're probably flying with Lothar, and let's hope he doesn't get killed. We're going on an escort mission. Yeah, so we're going to run into some interceptors. How far are we going? Oh, we're going for a ways. We're going on a bombing run. We're going across the front. I wish we were closer to the front. I don't like being that far away from the front. I like to get into action quick, so I'll be putting it on autopilot. I want to bore you guys with 30 minutes of flying to our target, because it will take like 30 minutes, 45 minutes. If I'm chilling by myself late at night, narcolepsy's kicking my ass, hemochromatosis, costochondritis, and then that fancy MS stuff, I'm up in the middle of the night for a little while. I'd like to cruise around and fly and take my time. So simple stuff, guys. So we're sitting at, I think it said 4,000 foot elevation, right? On. We're gonna escort some Rollins, bitchin'. Man, those are cool. I did fly those. Multiplayer with one of your pards, man. Cool. Let's take a look at the front. Good stuff. Let's fly. Need those incendiaries. Shoot some balloons down. No crashes. We put our black tails on there. I could not find a black fuselage for the Albatross D2. I wish we could switch to our D3. Come on, Wolfgang, get with it. I feel like I'm paralyzed. Every square inch of me. Yesterday I didn't eat because I couldn't make myself a meal. I have food. I'm physically unable. And that's what disabled is. They must be in D3s because they're just pulling right away from me. I'm supposed to have a D3 because I have a D3 paint scheme assigned, which means I have a D3. Plus I'm a 16 kill ace, which means I'd be getting the better planes. I shouldn't even be flying a D2. But they must be flying D3s because they're just pulling away from me. That scenery still looks good after all these years. Flying this and then flying Battlefield or Forgotten Hope 2, the World War II planes, Forgotten Hope 2, Battlefield 2, that sort of thing. That's arcade compared to this. I'm controlling every surface with just a little tiny twitch of my fingers. You guys know if you've flown Sims. Look at that bitchin' bridge down there, the shadows on the houses. Man, I'll tell you what. for a freaking 25-year-old game with a 21, 22-year-old mod, man, this still looks good. Is that ours? Nope. Maybe. There's 5, 6 of them. Yep, that's them. Oh man, those look cool. Check that out. I love that lozenge pattern, man. That's so awesome. Oh, that's fun, man. Look at that old bird. There's enemies in the area. Oh, that's so cool. Ah, look at this. It's so awesome. Yeah, we're going to get in some trouble. These two-seaters are not flying very high. I'm surprised. Bomb sites back during the Great War were below remedial. They were primitive. Our fighters are flying high. I bet you we're going to run into some interceptors coming up and a balloon. Shit, stall. I'm going to be redoing the skins, the upper wing, bottom wing, the elevator, and the fin, and the fuselages, and the wheels for Yasa-23B. So I'm going to be doing a little bit of work on the Bavarian squadrons before we start a campaign with my old squadron, Yasta-23B. Graugeist, Gottfried, Black Widow, who else? Otto von Stockel, Kevin, for the life of me, I can't remember Kevin's flight name. Balloons. We are hunting balloonatics, Baron. Yeah, we're going to run into some Newports, 17s. We're going to run into some Sopwith Pups. Man, right here, we're flying. The reason I'm flying this, man, this is the month of World War One. This is bloody April. This is the golden, this is the peak of the golden age of air combat is right here. Albatross D2s, Albatross D3s, okay? Then the D5s, the DR1s come out against Sopwith Pups, Newport 17s, the Americans enter the war. I mean, this area is full. If you were to ask me, like, if I should buy a book on just 1 year of the war, I'd have to say, personally, this one, 1917. We should almost be there. No balloons in sight. I'm surprised because we have an infantry position right below us. I should be able to eat tonight. I have to eat something. I haven't eaten since Thursday night at this time, so it's been 48 hours since I've eaten. So I'll have to eat something tonight. I'm below 150 pounds now. And deteriorating alone. And I have been for 3 years. Sometimes your family only turn out to be relatives, and your friends turn out to be your family. And if you're lucky enough to have friends that are family, even if your family are only relatives, you're a lucky number indeed. Fighters, they're coming up. Yep, they're coming up. Spads. Spad 7. not sure which squad, and that, yeah, must be another SPAD 7. Our planes are not attacking them. They're continuing on their flight. We'll stick with our flight. Because I sure as shit am not going to go down and take on a couple SPAD 7s by myself. That would be... Oh, there they go. They're dropping their bombs. Yeah, they already dropped them. Right. Yeah. So that was our bombing run. It looks like we damaged a hangar. Yeah, there's like a hangar over there on fire. Something's on fire. So we caught a couple of things on fire. There's enemies down there. There's enemies down there. I can see a bunch of them flying around. They're coming. They're coming. They're coming, Captain. Oh, no, no, no. Let's find out where what our flight's doing. We'll stick with our boys. We're not going to go take on a bunch of fighters by ourselves to be stupid. So I'm looking forward to maybe, hopefully, firing up IL-2 next week. IL-2, IL-246. But I want to play the 1916 mod for that. They have a World War I mod for IL-246. Oh, here they come. Right there. Yep, three of them. Four of them. Five of them. Six, seven. I see like seven fighter aircraft. Yep, they're coming. Target threat. Yeah, there's a bunch of them. It's like seven planes, seven fighters. And they're SPAD 7s. They're fast. They're sleek. They're very aerodynamic. SPAD 7s are fast. That's what we're flying in our Frank Luke campaign. Is a SPAD 7, early 1918. So they were flying those SPAD 7s for about a year. I have progressive, primary progressive multiple sclerosis, which means I'm not going to get better. There is no cure. I'm going to continue to progress and deteriorate every day until I'm gone. The funny thing is that multiple sclerosis isn't even my most dangerous illness. Hemochromatosis is. Hemochromatosis could kill me right now before I finish this flight. My shelf life on my liver was 2013. The only reason I'm still alive is because I eat a very strict diet. And I have for 15 years. Given that fact, most people with hemo don't make it past 65. I was born with it. And then on top of that, when you're diagnosed with multiple sclerosis, you automatically lose 7 years off your life. So how long do I have to go? Disability awareness message of the day. If you're a United States citizen, I would imagine in every state, if you scream and yell at a disabled person, you're looking at federal jail time. Don't raise your voice to a disabled person. You may do jail, counseling, and public service. Most people don't act on them. They blow it off. There's an enemy flight right there. Well, lucky us. Maybe we'll be able to catch them. Because by this time, by the end of the month, by the end of April, May, June, that next 3 months, the Allies, after April, they catch up in technology and speed. Early in the war, shit, we couldn't catch them because most of their aircraft were pusher type aircraft. They're faster. That was one correction I noticed. Historical inaccuracy, I know it's minor, but if you're an aficionado, if you're a fan of the era, armchair historian like myself, in the film, 2008 film, The Red Baron, they are talking about Voss's plane, Werner Voss's plane, and they're saying they found a Fokker DR-1 with a Bentley engine in it. It was Voss's plane, is what they were talking about. It wasn't a Bentley, it was a Lerone. Bentley's never mentioned in Voss's DR-1 at all, ever. I don't know why the writers would even choose that. It was Lerone in the DR-1. Yep, I'm drinking coffee at 8:30. Welcome to the world of narcolepsy, which honestly, coffee doesn't affect a doggone thing. I'll pass out right in the chair whether I drink a gallon of coffee or not. It sure does feel good in the morning, though. The only reason that I sleep a normal night is because of THC, and that's it. If I didn't have THC, my sleeping would be so erratic, it'd put you in a rubber room. It almost did put me in a rubber room. You sleep 2 hours on, you sleep 2 hours off. Forever. Me, that lasted for 10 months. 2 hours on, 2 hours off. I saw two people that whole year. Train depot, rail yard, they're probably fighters on a patrol. They're patrolling this, they're on a cap. I'm starting to wake up a little bit. When I started this recording, this broadcast, I was just waking up from a narcolepsy episode. Shit. Whoa, where'd you come from? I'm doing that on purpose. There's a guy behind me. My buttons are old, that's why it flickers like that. I'm not diving with you there, Sonny. You can lose your own altitude. You coming for me, boy? Rock and roll! Yeah! Missed him totally. See how much faster he is than me? Come on, just a little bit more. Man, he's so hard to see. He's so camoed up. shit! D2, man, on that turn. Trying to bring me down to those guns. Yeah, I knew it. I knew it. I knew he was back there. He's got me. Oh, he's got me. Oh, he's got me. I can hardly see these guys. They got some freaking altitude on me now. They drew me down. Wonder if I can get them to chase me under a bridge. Yeah, because now they've got me at their mercy. I'm barely freaking staying afloat. Whoa, I need to get some air. Must have not seen me. He could have taken me out right there. Yeah, I need to turn the aggressiveness up. I mean, they're a little aggressive. Oh, shit burgers. See another plane coming in. Oh, Oh, he's fighting somebody else. All right, so we got some help. Is this? Oh, he went down. I got him. I must have wounded him or something. We still have this other enemy over here, and it looks like he's fighting someone. Let's get some altitude before we die. Die by tree. Oh, he's coming. There was, he just had a dogfight. I could see it. Where's this? There he is. AI aggressiveness turned up to 110. I should put it on like 125. 100 is normal. I bumped it up to 110, and then they still just, I don't know, they don't seem as aggressive as they should be. Maybe I can give you guys an ace today, huh? I don't even know who we're fighting. We have no idea. Now, let's get some E and some altitude on him. Those two guys drove me down to the ground, man. Almost. Oh! A little stall-a-rooney. Always that doggone turn. Let's hope we make it home. He's hurting already, he's gotta be. I know I am, because I'm freaking stalling and flipping over to one side. Oh, there he is. Go down, fool. Yeah. Whew. Shit. Just Swiss cheese is undercarriage. Those things are tanks, man, I'm telling you. I turned the bullet mass factor up to 5 from 1, which means bullet mass factor, the bullets are going to do more damage on all the planes. Not just my planes, but all of them, the whole game. We'd be sitting here like using up a billion bullets just to down a plane. Man, this guy is invincible. Shit. Now I'm gonna get machine gun from the ground gunners. It's so hard to stay steady these days. Man, this guy will not go down. He's got a solid cement freaking SPAD 7. What's up? He's done. Done. Done by the Hun. We got him. Heck yeah. Bit of a long dog fight, but holy cow. Rock and roll. I didn't want to go home empty-handed. Shit. We are going the wrong way, kids. Let's go home. And I, you're witnessing it right here and now, at this very moment. I'm hungry. For the first time in 2 days, I'm actually hungry, so I'm gonna make some chicken and probably a potato. And I'm gonna finish watching 1917. I haven't watched the whole thing, I've watched half of it. I started watching it like a year ago, but I never finished it, and so I started watching it again last night. That beginning reel on our broadcast tonight is from a documentary called World War One in Color, and you can find it on YouTube. It's only about an hour, and it's really well done. World War One in Color, about this month, about Bloody April, Manfred von Richthofen, or Richthofen, it depends upon where you're from, north or south, across the pond. Trying to remember what I was doing just now. Looking for a balloon, baby. Looking for a balloon. Oh, there she is, sweeties. Oh, yes, my precious. Oh. Double gold mine. Rock and roll, we're gonna die. You know why we're gonna die, right? You know why we're gonna die, right? Because the freaking ground gunners. Now you guys know this, two more kills. We just shot down two SPAD 7s. This may be the really cool broadcast. I wish we were doing this on live stream. I'm really not well enough to live stream. I might later, I don't know. Maybe after I eat. We are going to win our Blue Max. So maybe we'll save that for a live stream. Oh, yeah. Fuck. Freaking ground gunners, you guys ready for this? Kill number 20. Right. Kill number 20. And freaking Archie is having their freaking field day with me, man. I freaking hate those ground gunners. That infantry gunners on the aircraft, they were more dangerous than the enemy's aircraft. Big time. Now if we can scoot our asses out of here, we might freaking get out of here. Line for home, baby. Look at this. Somebody's dropping bombs. Oh, shit. Doggone it. Fuck. Stay away from those freaking infantry positions. Damn it. We don't want to go that way. Don't want to go that way. Fly away from those freaking fools. Holy shit. Now we're probably going west again, but I got to get away from these guys. They're way too accurate. We're not exactly really high, but shit. Ground gunners are tearing me up. And I haven't messed with them or nothing. It's on, you know, stock vanilla full canvas jacket. I'm playing full canvas jacket Promised Land, which is a lot harder. The AI is better, flight models reworked, like everything. The AI is, yeah. You can change everything. The ground gunner's convergence and the AI's aggressiveness. We gotta try to get our way home. We need to head east, young man. Away from those freaking ground gunners. And we have low, low altitude. Bad, bad, bad. We get some enemies, some Newport 17s come up behind us. Here's these a-holes again. Come on, guys, you guys are like a mile away. You can't hit me. That's what the Red Baron said, huh? Those ground gunners, they cannot hurt me. We all know we talk like a Swede, right? All right, German infantry. German balloons. Let's go say hi. Let's try not to knock our wheels off this time. I've done it before. Not too close. Yeah, I have a knack for getting a little too close. Ah, that's so cool. That's so cool. Alright, boys, time to go home. We might run into some enemies along the way. Let's get some altitude. We're on our side of the lines. Yep, headed north. So I'm going to do a Yasta 23B. I'll probably fly as myself, probably as Otto Hohmuth. Otto Hohmuth was a known pilot from Yasta 23B who had interesting history. His plane was captured, that's why he's famous. We have an intact Albatross from Yasta 23B to play with. In real life, I'd love to go see where that plane is, what they ever did with it. He was forced down with, probably got his engine shot out. He landed with an intact airplane, probably a damaged motor. And the British captured the plane. Yeah, we should be right there, right? Right, right. Let's see if I get the... Nope, I don't want that. I want fly level enabled. There we go. Fly level enabled. And there's our drone. Throttle down. We always used to land with our engines off back in the 90s. It's weird though, in the single player game, like if you land with your engine off, I don't know if they consider that like a emergency landing or what. Nice and smooth, Warlord, nice and smooth. Let's try not to do a bouncy. Or as old Gottfried would say, a bouncy poo. Don't be doing a bouncy poo, Herr Rittmeister. Wounded. Hear the ambulance. I don't hear Irish Rev Twitch coming to pick us up. Pitching, bitching in the kitchen. Awesome, awesome. Kick ass. You guys, we had a good mission. It's a little long, doggone. We were chasing those T-Series forever. Freaking start with 18 seaters. We can never catch them. start of nation. Kessler was one of the most badass pilots I've ever seen in the Red Baron community. The good old days. Now, as you guys see, I can't keep... I used to get my crosshairs, like, right on him, and I would just, like, stay right on him, nailing him. Now I'm like, whoa. But it's still fun. I doubt you guys would have any gameplay issues when you're my age, you know, unless you get sick or something, because it's my balance and focus and stuff that throws me off. It's not judgment or anything like that. Hand-eye coordination. Age, a little bit. Age contributes to it a little bit, because I have friends who are older than me and they're sharper than tacks. They're sharp as a freaking samurai sword. Oh, so we lost one. We lost one roll in C2. We escorted our flight in friendly territory. Kick ass. 4DH4 from 55 RFC. Those are the ones that we saw and we chased all the way back across the front. The Siegfried line. My mother-in-law's name was Siegfried. She was a nice woman. She made the best damn Chesapeake Bay shad roe, man. Oh, that woman could cook. I was married in 1996 on a dock on the Chesapeake Bay with about a couple dozen World War II vets. They were having a reunion, turned our wedding into a reunion. That was cool. Schlasta 12. I'm going to change my name to Roland Schlasta. Monday morning in court, I'll magically teleport there from this chair. It'd be awesome. Escorted flight has landed at their base. Roland Schlasta. Ooh, I was fighting Raoul Luthberry from Escadrille Lafayette. Comment allez-vous? Sturm shot by Captain Luthberry. So we were fighting Luthberry. I had a feeling he was in one of those Newport 17s. The insignia on the side, though, wasn't an Indian head. They were like these round red circles. You guys saw it. It should have been an Indian head, is what that should be. So maybe it was two different planes from two different squads. Maybe they're both sharing the same aerodrome. Sturm damaged Captain Luthberry. Sturm damaged Captain Luthberry. Sturm shot by a SPAD 7 from Escadrille Newport 124. I wonder why they had different insignia on. They should have an Indian head, the Indian headdress. Lafayette, American, right on. Sturm damaged a SPAD 7. Yeah, so we were fighting Lafayette Escadrille. Sturm shot by Captain Luthberry. I have a feeling I got wounded. He messed my plane up because I can't remember, it's left or right turn when my wing surfaces were damaged and I couldn't control it in that turn, in that direction. I can't remember if it was right or left. Probably left. Why do I say probably left? Because it has a rotary engine and if you're sitting in the cockpit, it's turning clockwise. So if I'm trying to turn left, it's got G-forces from that rotary engine fighting against you. From turning, and then I would like flip. And so if I'm missing my control surfaces on my wings, that's why I was trying to stay up, man. I wonder if I got him. I downed him. I don't know if he's dead because it looked like one of them landed. One of them crashed and exploded. The other one we really never got confirmation on. I hope he's not shot down. I hope, because I'd like him to last into 1918. Then we shoot down all the aces. When we build up some skills, because your skills will build up and build up. You'll get better. You get better planes, et cetera, et cetera. You get better food. You get better music. You get better bunks. It's awesome. They even give you those fancy parachutes everyone's talking about. Captain Luthberry crashed. Sturm damaged SPAD. So the first one that went down was Luthberry. The first one that went down exploded. I hope he's not dead. Leutnant von Richthofen landed, so Lothar landed. Because Lufbery was cool, man. He's like, you watch him on film. You watch him on film, he would have been great to hang out with. He looked like a guy who was really fun to kick it with. Sturm damaged the SPAD 7 from Escadrille Newport to 124. He looked like a real party animal, yeah. Playing cards, drinking some whiskey, right on. So down there at their aerodrome, they had their mascots are two lions, okay? They had two lion cubs in the Lafayette Escadrille. Their names were Whiskey and Soda. That's what the Americans, that's the Americans' mascots that they brought with them. We brought lions. The Red Baron had a Great Dane named Fritz. No, Moritz, Moritz, M-O-R-I-T-Z. Yeah, the Red Baron had a Dane that he took with him. A Great Dane named Moritz. Yeah, always liked that name. We had a pilot in our squad named Moritz. Maybe that was Kevin's pilot name. I can't remember Kevin's pilot name. Me and Kevin are still follow each other on Twitter. I got that SPAD 7. I got shot by a machine gun. I see it when it says that you got shot by a machine gun. That's the roll of the dragon dice right there. Did I get wounded? I might land safely. Everything looks all cool. And then it's like you died from your wounds. And they're putting me in the ground. So that's pretty cool. Sturm damaged an Allied balloon. Sturm shot by an Allied machine gun. Albatross D3 from Yasta 4 landed. Yasta 4. Where are they at? They're right there at Douai as well. I'd sure like to find that 56 squadron, man. Ball, Albert Ball. He's hardcore. He's a freaking wild man. He didn't give a damn about wrecking his plane or nothing. Yeah, he, like you guys saw in the videos I shared at the beginning of the stream, he said it was all luck. And he'd bring his planes home and crash land them, and they were just shredded when he got there. Sturm landed end of mission. So how'd we do? After action report, we got 4 kills. Your mission was successful. So finally we got a successful mission, so we might get a promotion. Because we're due. We've got 20 victories now. Okay status. We got an okay aircraft. We got 4 victories, and we got a successful mission. This is the first time. I think this is the fifth or sixth mission. Probably the sixth mission for our Bloody April campaign. Out of 6 missions, we finally have a successful mission with kills, with okay status, with okay aircraft status. We're an unteroffizier, bottom of the barrel, bottom of rank. We got all the medals. We almost got the blue max. Give us a promotion to admiral. Cool beans, we did good. You inflicted few losses to the enemy. Shit, I shot down an ace, 2 SPAD 7s and a balloon. What do you want? All of the escorted planes made it back. They didn't. One of the planes crashed at the target. One of the Roland C2s crashed at the target. We saw it, yeah. Roland Schlasta. That's a good pilot name. Roland Schlasta. Cool, guys. Awesome. So we got a medal. Did we get the blue max? We got the blue max. We got the blue max. Yes. We got the blue max. Bitchin', 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 bitchin'. Awesome. So cool. Alfred Sturm was awarded the Ordre pour le Mérite in recognition of service above and beyond the call of duty on April 13th. I wonder what day it is. I wonder if it's Friday the 13th. I haven't seen that in so long. This image, I haven't seen that in over 10 years. Rock and roll. I love it. That's so cool. Love my Blue Max. My squad bought that for me. My friend Hal from Helmond in the Netherlands was one of our pilots, and he was great. Great young guy. And he sent me that out of the blue from the squad. A bunch of the guys got together, and for my 20th tournament victory, they actually bought me a Blue Max. That's pretty freaking awesome. Okay, so great victory for Germany. Army HQ in Berlin confirmed today that Raoul Luftberry from Escadrille Newport 124 Lafayette was brought down on 4/18/1917 while engaging our forces over the Western Front. Though the enemy was a skilled pilot, our airman Alfred von Sturm proved once again to be superior. Allied losses are mounting as Germany still commands the skies over Europe. And they do till 1918. So, no promotions, huh? Doggone, I guess we're going to have to do better. No promotions yet. We got our Blue Max, but no promotion. We're a freaking Unteroffizier. What's up with that? We should be a lieutenant. Come on, Leutnant, Oberleutnant. We will be a Hauptmann of our own squad, maybe Yasta 5, because Alfred Sturm actually flew for Yasta 5. Which are in the area, they were an elite squad. And they were mostly an escort squad. Yeah, but they were badass. Top aces. We're climbing up there. We are ahead of Kurt Wolf. We are ahead of Rene Dormez. Both famous aces. So we're climbing up there in the ranks with Neungesser himself. And if you guys remember, he was one of the first people who tried to cross the Atlantic, and he disappeared over the Atlantic, never to see it be seen again, is what happened to Neungesser. Right. Look at that. Rock and roll. Twenty kills. Rock and roll. Awesome, awesome, awesome. Anything? Nada. So my friends, thank you for tuning in. And I hope you guys enjoyed the game. And I hope to see you all live on Twitch sooner than later. I'm hoping that I will be feeling better sooner than later. So, I hope you guys are playing some awesome freaking games this weekend, you guys, and I hope your games, whatever you may be gaming, have a little bit of history in them. And so, my friends, if you guys stay tuned for this end message from the Multiple Sclerosis Society, the National Multiple Sclerosis Society, thanks for watching. Appreciate it. And sleep deep, rest well, and dream interesting dreams, all of you guys everywhere. Warlord over and out. And I hope to see you guys on Twitch tomorrow on Sunday. Rest well, my friends. Please be safe. Hope to hear from ya. Hope you guys are doing well.
Multiple sclerosis is a disease that impacts the brain and spinal cord, which make up the central nervous system that controls everything we do, whether it's taking a physical step or solving a complex problem. The exact cause of MS is unknown, but we do know that something triggers the immune system to attack the brain and spinal cord. The resulting damage to myelin that insulates wire-like nerve fibers is a disruption of signals to and from the brain. This interruption of communication signals causes unpredictable symptoms such as numbness, tingling, mood changes, memory problems, pain, fatigue, blindness, or paralysis. Everyone's experience with MS is different, and these losses may be temporary or long-lasting. Most people initially have relapsing remitting MS, where they experience attacks of new symptoms followed by periods of time when those symptoms go away partially or completely. Others experience gradual and ongoing loss of function without distinct attacks, which is known as progressive MS. MS can be difficult to diagnose, but once a diagnosis is confirmed by a neurologist who is knowledgeable about MS, there are disease-modifying therapies for reducing attacks and slowing down the damage. Growing evidence suggests that early and ongoing treatment with a disease-modifying therapy is an important defense against future attacks. There are also treatment strategies to address some MS symptoms. Options are still limited for slowing down or stopping progressive MS. Worldwide research is accelerating the discovery of how to slow down or even stop progressive MS, how to repair nervous system damage and restore function, wellness strategies such as exercise and diet that can help people with MS to live their best lives, and the exact cause of MS so that it may be prevented for future generations. To learn more about multiple sclerosis, connect with others to drive research for a cure, and to address the challenges of everyone affected by MS, visit nationalmssociety.org or call 1-800-344-4867.